This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Independent is a British online newspaper established in 1986 as an independent national morning newspaper published in London. It was controlled by Tony O'Reilly's Independent News. 11/1986 to 1990/12/1990 to present 2 content 21 format and design 22 front pages 23 sections 24 online presence 3 political views 4 personnel 41 editors 42 writers and columnists 43 photographers 5 Longford Prize 6 related publications 61 The Independent on Sunday 62 The I 63 The Red Independent 7 awards and nominations 8 See also 9 References 10 External links History 1986-1990 Launched in 1986, the first issue of The Independent was published on 7 October in broadsheet format. It was produced by Newspaper Publishing PLC and created by Andreas Whittam Smith, Stephen Glover and Matthew Simmons. All three partners were former journalists at the Daily Telegraph who had left the paper towards the end of Lord Hartwell's ownership. Marcus Seif was the first chairman of Newspaper Publishing, and Whittam Smith took control of the paper. The paper was created at a time of a fundamental change in British newspaper publishing. Rupert Murdoch was challenging long-accepted practices of the print unions and ultimately defeated them in the Wapping dispute. Consequently, production costs could be reduced, which, it was said at the time, created openings for more competition. As a result of controversy around Murdoch's move to Wapping, the plant was effectively having to function under siege from sacked print workers. Picketing outside The Independent attracted some of the staff from the two Murdoch broadsheets who had chosen not to move to his company's new headquarters, launched with the advertising slogan "It is our you," and challenging both The Guardian for centre-left readers and The Times as the newspaper of record. The Independent reached a circulation of over 400,000 by 1989, competing in a moribund market. The Independent sparked a general freshening of newspaper design as well as, within a few years, a price war in the market sector. When The Independent launched The Independent on Sunday in 1990, sales were less than anticipated, partly due to the launch of the Sunday Correspondent 4 months prior. Although this direct rival closed at the end of November 1990, some aspects of production merged with the main paper. Although the Sunday paper retained a largely distinct editorial staff 1990 to present in the 1990s, The Independent was faced with price cutting by the Murdoch titles, and started an advertising campaign accusing The Times and The Daily Telegraph of reflecting the views of their proprietors, Rupert Murdoch and Conrad Black. It featured spoofs of the other paper's mastheads with the words "The Rupert Murdoch" or "The Conrad Black," with The Independent below the main title. Newspaper Publishing had financial problems. A number of other media companies were interested in the paper. Tony O'Reilly's Media Group and Mirror Group Newspapers MGN had bought a stake of about a third each by mid-1994. In March 1995, Newspaper Publishing was restructured with a rights issue, splitting the shareholding into O'Reilly's Independent News. In November 2008, following further staff cuts, production was moved to Northcliffe House, in Kensington High Street, the headquarters of Associated Newspapers. The two newspaper groups' editorial, management and commercial operations remained separate, but they shared services including security, information technology, switchboard and payroll. On 25 March 2010, Independent News Crozier, who was executive editor, design and picture, from pre-launch in 1986 to 1994. From September 2003, the paper was produced in both broadsheet and tabloid-sized versions, with the same content in each. The tabloid edition was termed compact to distance itself from the more sensationalist reporting style usually associated with tabloid newspapers in the UK. After launching in the London area and then in North West England, the smaller format appeared gradually throughout the UK soon afterwards. Rupert Murdoch's Times followed suit, introducing its own tabloid-sized version. Prior to these changes, The Independent had a daily circulation of around 217,500, the lowest of any major national British daily, a figure that climbed by 15% as of March 2004 to 250,000 throughout much of 2006. Circulation stagnated at a quarter of a million on 14 May 2004. The Independent produced its last weekday broadsheet, having stopped producing a Saturday broadsheet broadsheet edition in January. The Independent on Sunday published its last simultaneous broadsheet on 9 October 2005, and has since followed a compact design on 12 April 2005. The Independent redesigned its layout to a more European feel, similar to France's Libération. The redesign was carried out by a Barcelona-based design studio. The weekday second section was subsumed within the main paper, double-page feature articles became common in the main news sections, and there were revisions to the front and back covers. A new second section, Extra, was introduced on 25 April 2006. It is similar to The Guardian's G2 and The Times's Times 2, containing features, reportage and games, including Sudoku. In June 2007, The Independent on Sunday consolidated its content into a news section which included sports and business, and a magazine focusing on life and culture. On 23 September 2008, the main newspaper became full color, and Extra was replaced by an Independent Life supplement, focusing on different themes each day. 3 weeks after the acquisition of the paper by Alexander Lebedev and Yevgeny Lebedev in 2010, the paper was relaunched with another redesign on 20 April. The new format featured smaller headlines and a new pullout Viewspaper section, which contained the paper's comment and feature articles from 26 October 2010, the same day as its sister paper, I, was launched. The Independent was printed on slightly thicker paper than before and ceased to be full color throughout, with many photographs and pictures, though none of those used in adverts, being printed in black and white. Only on 11 October 2011, The Independent unveiled yet another new look, featuring a red, sans-serif masthead in November 2013. The whole newspaper was overhauled again, including new custom fonts and a vertical masthead in black front pages following the 2003 switch in format. The Independent became known for its unorthodox and campaigning front pages, which frequently relied on images, graphics or lists rather than traditional headlines and written news content. For example, following the Kashmir earthquake in 2005, it used its front page to urge its readers to donate to its appeal fund, and following the publication of the Hutton Report into the death of British government scientist David Kelly, its front page simply carried the word whitewash. In 2003, the paper's editor, Simon Kellner, was named Editor of the Year at the What the Papers Say Awards, partly in recognition of, according to the judges, his often arresting and imaginative front page designs. In 2008, however, as he was stepping down as editor, he stated that it was possible to overdo the formula and that the style of the paper's front pages perhaps needed reinvention. Under the subsequent editorship of Chris Blackhurst, the campaigning, poster-style front pages were scaled back in favor of more conventional news stories sections. The weekday, Saturday and Sunday editions of The Independent all included supplements and pull-out subsections, daily Monday to Friday The Independent, Monday Sport, a weekly pull-out containing reports of the previous weekend's sporting events. Saturday's The Independent, Saturday Sport, a weekly pull-out containing reports looking ahead to the weekend's sporting events. Radar, a compact, primarily listings magazine, including television schedules, film and DVD reviews and events listings for the coming week. It also includes a roundup of the 50 best items in a particular category. For example, over the Christmas period there are weekly supplements of Gifts for Him and Gifts for Her. Traveler, contains travel articles and advertisements. The Independent Magazine, a features magazine including sections on food, interiors and fashion. The Independent on Sunday Sport, a weekly pull-out containing reports of Saturday's sporting events. The New Review, a features magazine. Arts Service, priority on image and video content, and additional areas of the site including art, architecture, fashion, gadgets and health. The paper launched podcast programs such as The Independent Music Radio Show, The Independent Travel Guides, The Independent Sailing Podcasts, and The Independent Video Travel Guides. Since 2009, the website has carried short video news bulletins provided by the Al Jazeera English News Channel. In 2014, The Independent launched a sister website, i100, a shareable journalism site with similarities to Reddit and Upworthy. Political views. When the paper was established in 1986, the founders intended its political stance to reflect the center of the British political spectrum and thought that it would attract readers primarily from The Times and The Daily Telegraph. It has been seen as leaning to the left, making it more a competitor to The Guardian. Although both also feature conservative columnists, The Independent tends to take a classical liberal, pro-market stance on economic issues. In an editorial on 27 January 2013, The Independent on Sunday referred to itself as a proudly liberal newspaper. The paper took a strong editorial position against the 2003 invasion of Iraq, the Iraq War, and aspects of U.S. and U.K. foreign policy related to the war on terrorism following the 11th of September attacks. It has been a strong supporter of electoral reform. The paper has also taken strong positions on environmental issues, campaigned against the introduction of ID cards, and campaigned against the restriction of mass immigration to the UK in 1997. The Independent on Sunday launched a campaign for the decriminalisation of cannabis 10 years later. It reversed itself, claiming that the cannabis strain skunk smoked by the majority of young Britons in 2007 had become 25 times stronger than resin sold a decade ago. In addition, The Independent has highlighted what it refers to as war crimes being committed by pro-government forces in the Darfur region of Sudan. Originally, it avoided royal stories, Whitam Smith later saying he thought the British press was unduly besotted with the royal family and that a newspaper could manage without stories about the monarchy. In 2007, Alan Rusbridger, editor of The Guardian, said of The Independent, "The emphasis on views, not news, means that the reporting is rather thin, and it loses impact on the front page the more you do that." In a 12 June 2007 speech, British Prime Minister Tony Blair called The Independent a viewspaper, saying it was started as an antidote to the idea of journalism as views not news. That was why it was called The Independent. Today it is avowedly a viewspaper, not merely a newspaper. The Independent criticised Blair's comments the following day but later changed format to include a viewspaper insert in the centre of the regular newspaper, designed to feature most of the opinion columns and arts reviews. A leader published on the day of the 2008 London mayoral election compared the candidates and said that, if the newspaper had a vote, it would vote first for the Green Party candidate, Sean Berry, noting the similarity between her priorities and those of The Independent, and secondly, with rather heavy heart, for the incumbent. Ken Livingstone, an Ipsos Mori poll estimated that in the 2010 general election, 44% of regular readers voted Liberal Democrat, 32% voted Labour, and 14% voted Conservative, compared to 23%, 29%, and 36%, respectively, of the overall electorate on the eve of the 2010 general election. The Independent supported the Liberal Democrats, arguing that they are long-standing and convincing champions of civil liberties, sound economics, international cooperation on the great global challenges and, of course, fundamental electoral reform. These are all principles that this newspaper has long held dear. That is why we argue that there is a strong case for progressively minded voters to lend their support to the Liberal Democrats wherever there is a clear opportunity for that party to win. However, the weekend before the 2015 general election saw The Independent on Sunday claim it would not be advising its readers how to vote in 2015. The editorial piece claimed that this does not mean that we are a bloodless, value-free news sheet. We have always been committed to social justice, but the paper recognized that it was up to the readers to make up your own mind about whether you agree with us or not. Rather than support a particular party, the paper urged all its reader to vote as a responsibility of common citizenship. On 4 May 2015, the weekday version of The Independent said that a continuation of the conservative-liberal-democrat coalition after the general election would be a positive outcome. Personnel editors: The Independent, 1986, Andreas Whitam Smith, 1994, Ian Hargreaves, 1995, Charles Wilson, 1996, Andrew Marr, 1998, Rosie Boycott, 1998, Andrew Marr and Rosie Boycott, 1998, Simon Kellner, 2008, Roger Alton, 2010, Simon Kellner 2011, Chris Blackhurst 2013, Amol Rajan. The Independent on Sunday. 1990, Stephen Glover 1991, Ian Jack 1995, Peter Wilby 1996, Rosie Boycott 1998, Kim Fletcher 1999, Janet Street Porter 2002, Tristan Davies 2008, John Mullen 2013, Lisa Markwell. There have also been various guest editors over the years, such as Elton John on 1 December 2010, The Body Shop's Anita Roddick on 19 June 2003 and U2's Bono in 2006. Writers and columnists predominantly in The Independent. This is a dynamic list and may never be able to satisfy particular standards for completeness. You can help by expanding it with reliably sourced entries. Yasmin Alibi Brown, Bruce Anderson, Paul Arden, Archie Bland, Andrew Brown, Ryder Cooper Brown, Michael Brown, Simon Calder, Alexa Chung, Rob Cowan, Sloane Crosley, Tracy Emin, Nigel Farage, Mitch Firestein, Helen Fielding, Robert Fisk, Chris Gulker, Howard Jacobson, Alex James, Peter Jenkins, Owen Jones. Ryder Andrew Keane, Dominic Lawson, John Litchfield, Philip Llewellyn, Andy McSmith, Donald McIntyre, Serena McCassey, Tracy McLeod, Rodri Marsden, Jan McGurk, Deborah Orr, Christina Patterson, Peter Popham, Simon Reed, Steve Richards, Sharif Saleh, Alexei Sale, Will Self, Mark Steele, Catherine Townsend, Paul Vailey, Brian Viner, Lynn Walker, Andreas Whittem Smith, Claudia Winkleman. Predominantly The Independent on Sunday, this is a dynamic list and may never be able to satisfy particular standards for completeness. You can help by expanding it with reliably sourced entries. Janet Street Porter, Editor-at-Large Kate Bassett, Theodore Patrick Cockburn, John Rentoul, Joan Smith, Paul Vailey and Alan Watkins, comment. Christopher Hurst and Lucinda Rogers, The Weasel, Weekly Illustrated Column 1995-2008. Dom Jolie, first up, in the Sunday Review. Tim Minogue and David Randall, Observatory, Cole Moriton, News Analysis, Regular Double Spread. Anna Picard, Opera and Classical. Simon Price, Rock and Pop Photographers. Timothy Allen, Longford Prize. The Independent sponsors the Longford Prize, in memory of Lord Longford-related publications. The Independent on Sunday. Type Sunday Newspaper Editor Lisa Markwell. Circulation 155,661. ISSN 0958-1723. OCLC number 500,339,994. The Independent on Sunday. The Independent on Sunday was the Sunday sister newspaper of The Independent. It ceased to exist in 2016 when the latter stopped being printed. The I main article, I newspaper, in October 2010. The I, a compact sister newspaper, was launched. The I is a separate newspaper but uses some of the same material. The Red Independent. The Independent supported U2 lead singer Bono's product Red brand by creating the Red Independent, an occasional edition that gave half the day's proceeds to the charity. The first edition was in May 2006, edited by Bono. It drew high sales. A September 2006 edition of the Red Independent, designed by fashion designer Giorgio Armani, drew controversy due to its cover shot, showing model Kate Moss in blackface for an article about AIDS in Africa. Awards and nominations. The Independent was awarded National Newspaper of the Year for 2003, and The Independent on Sunday was awarded Front Page of the Year for 2014. Here is the news, not the propaganda, printed on 5 October 2014. Independent journalists have won a range of British press awards, including Business. See also Independent Foreign Fiction Prize. Brett Straub. Incident references. Carrot A. B. William Turvill. Amol Rajan is made editor of The Independent as Chris Blackhurst becomes group content director. Press Gazette, 17 June 2013. Carrot circulation figures. Press Gazette, 10 July 2015. Carrot A. B. Independent to cease as print edition. BBC News, 12 February 2016. Retrieved 12 February 2016. Carrot AB will be Peter the 14th of April 2008. It is as he. The Guardian London retrieved the 27th of March 2010. Titles to relocate to Associated Newspapers HQ. The Guardian London retrieved the 28th of November 2008. The Guardian London retrieved the 27th of March 2010. 2008. Editor met Piers Morgan. The Independent London. Carrot editorial in defense of liberal democracy. The Independent, 4 May 2015. Carrot Press Awards winners 2000-08, 16 March 2004. Retrieved 2 April 2016. Daily Express, Daily Gazette, Daily Gazetteer, Daily Herald, The Independent, Daily News, Daily Sketch, Daily Sport, The Day, Financial News, Financier and Bullionist, Greyhound Express, The Hour, Indicator, Jewish Times, The Morning Chronicle, Morning Herald, Morning Leader, The Morning Post, Morning Standard, Morning Star, New Daily, The New Day, News Chronicle, The Post, Sporting Chronicle, Sporting Life, The Sportsman, 1865, The Sportsman, 2006, Today, Sundays, Empire News, Independent on Sunday, Lloyd's Weekly Newspaper, National News, News of the World News on Sunday, The Planet on Sunday, Reynolds News, Sunday Business, Sunday Chronicle, Sunday Correspondent, Sunday Dispatch, Sunday Evening Telegram, Sunday Graphic, Sunday Illustrated, Sunday Referee, Sunday Special, Sunday Sportsman, Sunday Today, Sunday Worker, Weeklies, Athletic News, The Age, Early Times, The Era, The European, The Examiner, The Graphic, The Illustrated, London News, The Leader, Mark Lane Express, The Sphere, The Weekly, True Sun, Regional London Evening Newspapers, The Echo, Evening News, Evening Post, Evening Times, The Globe, Jewish Evening News, London Evening News, London Evening Post, London Light, The Pall Mall Gazette, St. James's Gazette, The Star, The Sun, True Sun, The Westminster Gazette, Whitehall Evening Post, Dailies, Birmingham Evening Dispatch, Bristol Mercury, Bristol Evening World, Burnley Evening Star, Chatham Evening Post, Chelmsford Evening Herald, Daily Post, Darlington Evening Dispatch, Doncaster Evening Post, Edinburgh Evening Dispatch, Evening Citizen, Glasgow Hereford Evening News, Huddersfield Daily Chronicle, Eastern Morning News, Hull Glasgow Evening News, Jewish Post and Gazette, London Jewish Times, London Kent Today, Leicester Daily Post, Leicester Evening Mail, Liverpool Courier, Liverpool Daily Post, Liverpool Evening Express, London Daily News, the London paper, Luton Evening Post, Manchester Evening Chronicle, Northern Whig, Belfast, Nottingham Daily Express, Nottingham Evening News, Nottingham Journal, Scottish Daily News, Shields Evening News, Southern Daily Mail, Portsmouth Slough Evening Mail, Surrey Daily Advertiser, Watford Evening Echo, Yorkshire Evening News, Sundays Sunday Pink, Manchester Sunday Sentinel, Stoke Western Independent, Plymouth Yorkshire on Sunday Weeklies, Brighton Herald, Leeds Mercury, Truman's Exeter, Flying Post, Other British Journal, Caledonian Mercury, Thrice Weekly Related, Burnie Collection of Newspapers, Category Authority Control, WorldCat Identities, VIAF, 206,862,173 GND, 4,415,347-8 BNF, CB 124,072,967 Data NDL, 0062823239.